Assalamu alaikum friends. Welcome to this MATLAB tutorial. Today I am going to teach you how to design closed loop boost converter using PID controller in MATLAB Simulink software. Furthermore, in the end of this video, I will discuss more than 10 new research ideas on how this closed loop boost converter can be used to complete your bachelor degree FYP project, master degree research, or one of the PhD research objective. Look at the figure which shows the block diagram of closed loop boost converter. It may be noted that highlighted portion is similar to the open loop boost converter model. It means we have to design the bottom circuit to convert this open loop boost converter into closed loop boost converter model. Friends, before going to start its designing, I want to highlight here that I have already made the video on this open loop boost converter model with the title on how to design boost converter in MATLAB Simulink software. Therefore, I would like to strongly suggest you to watch this video first for understanding the basics of this model. In order to save the time, I am going to start the designing from the closed loop boost converter portion. Let's start. First, come to MATLAB screen. You can see I have already opened the open loop boost converter Simulink model. Let's first save it. You may save it with any name of your choice and in any folder. Look at the figure. To design the closed loop boost converter, first we need the constant block having the reference voltage of 20 volt. It is because we want the output voltage of 20 volt. To get this, go to Simulink library. Take this constant block from here and bring it in the model. Now double click on this block, put here 20 volt value and press OK. Look at the figure again. It may be noted that now we need to connect the subtract block and gain block which has the magnitude of 1 upon 20. Therefore, come to model again. Take this gain block from here and bring it in the model. Similarly, take this subtract block from here and bring it in the model. Connect the constant block with the positive terminal of the subtract block. Similarly, connect the gain block with the output of the subtract block. Now double click on this gain block, put here 1 upon 20 value and press OK. Look at the figure again. Now we need to connect the PID controller block. It may be noted that here discrete PID controller is used. Therefore, come to model again. Take this PID controller block from here and bring it in the model. Connect this PID controller block here. Now double click on this block. Click on discrete time in order to make it discrete controller. Now click on PID advanced option. Enable this limit output. Put here the upper and lower limit of 0.9 and 0.1 respectively. Friends, most of the times PI controller is preferred as compared to the PID controller. Therefore, it is now your choice which controller you want to use here. I am going to use PI controller here. For this purpose, in the controller section, select the PI controller and press OK. Look at the figure again. Now we need to connect the relational operator block. Therefore, come to model. Take this relational operator block from here and bring it in the model. connect this block with the output of the PID controller block. Look at the figure again. Now we need to connect the repeating sequence block. Therefore, come to model. Take this repeating sequence block from here and bring it in the model. Connect this block with the relational operator block as shown here. Now double click on this block. We have to put the value for time period. To get this value, we know that according to data, it has switching frequency of 25 kHz. Due to this, its time period will be equal to 400 microseconds as calculated here. Therefore, come to model and put here 40 microseconds value, whereas in the output, replace 2 with the 1 and press OK. As we have connected the repeating sequence block here, therefore now this pulse generator block is not required. Therefore, remove this pulse generator block. Connect the output port of the relational operator with the MOSFET gate pulse input. Similarly, connect the second port of this subtract block with the output of the boost converter in order to complete the closed loop boost converter circuit. Now we need the display block to see the values. Therefore, take this display block from here and bring it in the model. Connect this display block at the feedback loop as well as at the output port of the PID controller. Now we have to change the setting of the power GUI block from continuous mode to discrete mode. Therefore, double click on it. You can see it is fixed. To make it flexible, so that we can change the settings, we have to change to solver. To do this, go to simulation and click on model configuration parameters. A new window will open. Hit solver tab. Change the auto solver to discrete here and press OK. Now double click on power GUI block. You can see now you can change the simulation type from continuous to discrete. Now it asks about the sampling time. For better results, put here sampling time of 0.5 microseconds and press OK. Change the simulation time to 1 second. Now you can run the simulation by clicking on this play button. You can see the output voltage is still not equal to 20 volt. Friends, our model is correct, but now we have to tune the parameters of the PI controller again and again in order to get the desired output voltage. After several simulations, the parameters of P and I which provides the satisfactory response are 0.7 and 100 respectively. Put the values of proportional and integral gain as 0.7 and 100 respectively. Now run the simulation again to see the results. Double click on this scope. You can see it has provided the desired output voltage. Furthermore, if you observe its mean value, it gives 19.91 volt, which is very close to 20 volt. Friends, now I am going to discuss the last important point which I mentioned in the beginning of this video, that what other research ideas can be added in this model to extend this research. To complete your bachelor degree FYP project, master degree research, are one of the PhD research objectives. Friends, this closed loop boost converter can also be used in the solar energy resources such as grid-connected PV model. Furthermore, as we have observed that PID controller needs proper tuning of its parameters to provide the satisfactory response. Therefore, now we have two other options. In the first option, we may replace this PID controller with latest intelligent controllers, such as Fuzzy Logic controller. In that case, the topic will become Fuzzy Logic controller based closed loop boost converter. Friends, I have already made the videos on Fuzzy Logic controller series to understand its basic with the title How to Implement Fuzzy Logic Control in MATLAB Simulink. This Fuzzy series consists of 3 parts. Therefore, you may watch this video series if you want to apply Fuzzy Logic controller on this model. Furthermore, you can also use artificial neural network as an intelligent controller. Again, I have already made the videos on artificial neural network series to understand its basic with the title How to Implement Artificial Neural Network in MATLAB Simulink. This ANN series consists of 4 parts. Therefore, you may watch this video series if you want to apply artificial neural network on this model. Furthermore, artificial neural network also has many types such as radial basis function neural network or probabilistic neural network. You may also use the combination of artificial neural network and fuzzy logic controller, namely adaptive neuro-fuzzy inference system. Friends, I have already made the videos on adaptive neuro-fuzzy inference system series to understand its basic with the title How to Implement Adaptive Neuro-Fuzzy Inference System in MATLAB Simulink. This ENFIS series consists of 2 parts. Therefore, you may watch this video series if you want to apply ENFIS controller on this model. Furthermore, you may also use support vector machine model as an intelligent controller. In the second option, we can use the PID controllers and try to optimize its parameter using the latest optimization techniques, such as ant colony optimization technique. In that case, your topic will become the ant colony optimization based closed loop boost converter. You may also add B colony optimization technique, particle swarm optimization technique, firefly optimization, bacterial foraging optimization technique, or you may use any other latest optimization technique in this model to extend your research. Friends, I have shared with you more than 10 new research ideas that can be used on this closed loop boost converter model. For your convenience, I have uploaded this closed loop boost converter model in the form of link in the description section of this video. For this purpose, go to the description section of this video. You can see the link is available here. You just need to copy this link from the description, paste it in the Google, and press enter, or simply click on this link. This new window will be opened, which contains the closed loop boost converter model. Now click on this button to download this folder. Now click on start download. You can see it has downloaded the folder. Now click on open folder to see the location of this folder. Now right click on it and click on cut. And bring it in any drive or folder where you want to place it. Or create new folder, give it any name of your choice and paste it here. Now right click on this folder and click on extract. You can see it has extracted the folder. Double click on this folder to open it. You can see it contains the PDF file as well as Simulink model of the closed loop boost converter. Now to open it in MATLAB software correctly, go to MATLAB software screen. Go to E drive or where you have saved this folder in order to bring this folder in the MATLAB as shown here. You can see closed loop boost converter model folder is available here. Now double click on it. You can see Simulink model of the closed loop boost converter is available here. Double click on this model to open it in Simulink. Wait for few seconds. You can see Simulink has opened this model correctly. Now you can run the simulation as discussed in this video. You can see it is working fine. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel, and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.